Om Sam Saraswati Namaha, Namaste. And this evening on page 90 of the Kashyapa Sutras, included in the book Shree Maa, the Guru and the Goddess, we're going to discuss Sutra number 15. And Sutra number 15 says to us, Sri Guru Nath, Sarva Karana Karana. So our first sutra said, Prarabdha Vashat Janma. You took birth because of unfinished business. And the 14th sutra said that the Advaita Anantam Bimuktastana. That means that the ultimate limit of non-duality is the residence of he who resides in self-realization. And now, our last sutra says, it's all the grace of the Guru. It's all, she is the cause of all the causes. So Sri means Shree Maa, the respected. Sri means respect, and Sha means Shanti, and Ra, oh, well, I said that. Maybe I'll just read you the text. Ra means your mind, and E means your heart, and the peace in your mind, and the peace in your heart is respect. When you look at something and listen to something with just pure awe. Without thinking about it, without qualifying it, without defining it, without classifying it, without making, imposing your opinions, then that's respect. And Guru is Gu Karas Twandakaras Cha, Ru Karas Teja Uchate, again Agrastakam Brahma, Guru Eva Nashamshaya, Nashamshaya, without a doubt. The respected, the word gu means darkness, the ru means light, the supreme divinity which destroys ignorance is verily the guru without a doubt. She's the light, my darkness. And the respected guru is the cause of all causes, sarva karana, karana. She is the cause of all the karana of all the karans, sarva, all, completely. Full, complete, perfect. So the divine guru is our example. The guru is our teacher. The guru is the cause of all causes. The guru is our inspiration. Shree is respect. Shree is the highest wealth. Shree is tejas or illumination. Shree, sa means peace. Ra means in your mind. E means in your heart. Ra means in your concepts and E means in your intuition. The highest respect to all creation is to perceive all with perfect equanimity, with peace in your mind and in your heart. Shree Guru Nathah is the respected example who illuminates our darkness. It is not an intellectual, but an intuitive awareness. The perfect absorption of the inspiration, the attitude, the example of the guru, with peace in your mind and in your heart. That's what it means to be in love. You got this feeling of peace, this attitude of energy, this focus of attention. You got your heart and your mind are in the same place. They're not off in different directions. Sri Guru Nath is the respected example who illuminates our darkness. It is not an intellectual, but an intuitive awareness. The perfect absorption of the inspiration, attitude, and example of the Guru is Sarva Karana Karanam, the cause of all causes. The perfect stillness in the awareness, the absorption of the example, of the inspiration in our lives is the cause of all progress on our path. This is the cause of all causes in reaching the destination. At the destination, we find the perfect illumination of respect which the Guru has disseminated by taking away the darkness. the greatest obstacle for all of humanity caught in this maya of objects and relationships is selfishness. Sri Guru Nath means we humble ourselves in such a way as to surrender all our selfishness in respect to the Guru, the supreme divine Guru who is Lord to us, not the Lord to us, and thereby we perceive the Guru as the cause of all causes. The cause of all causes is beyond the individual objects of consciousness, specifically that which is universal. It is shamashti instead of vyakti, universal or cosmic as compared with individual. And Shree Maa sings the song.
I will.
And Shree Maa sings the song.
I will.
Yes, you will. It says it in the book. I just read the book.
Shakoli tomari cha icha moi tara tumi tomari karma tumi karma loke male kari.
Just read the English.
Okay.
Everything is your desire, supreme desire, O dear mother. All action you perform, Ma, still people say that I have done. Everything is your desire. This bird of mind, it roams about, flies from mountain peaks and dales. Bring him down, Ma, and make him stop, resting at your lotus feet. Everything is your desire. I am a tool, and you are a craftsman. I am a house, and you are the master. I am a car, you are the driver. Just as you drive, just so I run. Everything is your desire. Everything is your desire, supreme desire, O dear mother. All action you perform, Ma, still people say that I have done. Everything is your desire. Well, the entire Guru Gita could be a commentary on this song. The shlokas of this song is expounded upon in the Guru Gita. But Sri Guru Nath, Sarva Karana Karanam, is exactly, she is the cause of all causes. Everything is your desire, Mom. Mm-hmm. And just as you drive, just so I run. Mm-hmm. Good. Well, Guru is the cause of all causes. Namaste. And Shree Maa speaks in Bengali, and Swami requests Maa to speak with more simple vocabulary, because she gets pretty sophisticated. And you have to understand, Mother often speaks and writes extremely sophisticated Bengali, so much so that I have a difficult time understanding. And Swami translates, "Please decipher and weigh the ultimate principles of all existence. Sort through the ultimate principles of all the ideals of creation. In order to realize the ultimate ideals of existence, your life should be dedicated to your spiritual discipline. Real human life is devoted completely to spiritual evolution." Mother would like to describe some of the attitudes through which we can devote ourselves to the realization of these ultimate ideals. Peacefulness in your nature is the foremost amongst the energies. Cultivate peace. You yourself will understand if your actions bring you peace or are actually leading you in another direction. In order to know God, it is most efficient to study the Sanskrit language. In the language of Sanskrit, there is an illumination of the wisdom of the soul. From the study of Sanskrit, certain attitudes arise and become illuminated. The attitude of wisdom in all ideals of perfection is one. These vibrations become apparent in the study of Sanskrit. When you realize wisdom, then you illuminate truth, consciousness, and bliss, within which there exists no distinction of individual attributes. Especially among paths or ideals of perfection, no discrimination exists. Always strive to maintain a relationship with the attitude of truth. When we remain steadfast in the attitude of the ideal of perfection, then our ideal becomes firmly rooted in strength. Our ideals become stronger. Then a sense of satisfaction and contentment resides within. When contentment dwells inside, then outside is characterized by the illumination of light, and we disseminate light in every circumstance. That illumination is the highest ideal. Strive to contain the ego. Maintain the recollection that God within you is performing all action. Shakali tumaricha. Remember who you are. Who am I? I am nobody. Remembering truth is meditation. In whatever circumstance you reside, remember who is residing there, and there will be no concept of gain or loss, difficulty or comfort. When you remain in this attitude of truth, this is satsang. This is communion with truth. Cultivating this attitude, you establish a pattern for the mind to sit still. When the mind sits still, then the reflections of thoughts will decrease. Always remain awake, alert. This is a form of purifying austerities. This is simple. And Ma adds, you can write volumes in English about words which are common in Sanskrit and never quite find an accurate definition. There are just so many subtleties. And Swamiji adds, every time Shree Maa speaks just a few words, we have to write another book. Om Sam Saraswati Namaha. Before we take questions, let's just quickly take a look at our glossary which follows this page. this last chapter of the Kashyapa Sutra, we define all dharma as in derogation of the ideal, otherwise known as evil, whereas dharma is the ideal, which is the good, because that's what I want. And advaitya is non-duality, and that's different from advaitya. But advaitya is non-duality in the sense of Vedanta, which is the description of the status of non-duality. Whereas Adhaitya is the name of an individual who is always dwelling in that state of Adhaitya. Aham is the sense of ego I, and Ahamkar is the ego, the sense of I. Aim, the vibration or natural name of wisdom, Aja, unborn, Aja. Continuous recitation without count of recitation, akshar, a letter, the unqualified infinite. A month without count or infinite. Anamaya kosh is the world of atoms, that which is perceivable through the senses. Antakaran, the inner cause or inner sense. Remember, it's comprised of man, buddhi, chitta, and ahamkar. Those four are the antakara. Antam, at the apex, at the end of, the ultimate living, a limit. Anu, or atoms. Ankaram, abundance, a source. Apana, exhalation. Asuras, the force of forces of individuality, as contrasted with devas, or the shining ones, or the forces of unity. Amamba, bliss. Anandamaya kosh, the world or the paradigm, the consistency of bliss, the covering of bliss, the envelope of bliss. Aradhana, the pleasing, satisfying, fulfilling. Asan is your seat or your meditation posture. Ashram is a place of refuge, and actually shram means effort, and ashram is a place where there's no effort. Oh my goodness. And in that sense, it's the place of refuge, because you take refuge. She does all the effort. The guru does all the, she is the cause of all causes. She does all the effort, and all the rest of us just hang out in the kitchen and talk about good things. Atma samarpan, to surrender one's own soul. Bandhan, bound by, bandhana is bondage. Bhagwan, the Supreme Lord. Bhakti is a devotee, and bhakti is her devotion.
Bandhana, why bondage?
Bandhana is a key, the bandhana, bandhan kochi.
Oh, I thought bandhana is another bandhana is prayer.
No, that's bandhana. Bandhana. Bandhana is a bandhan kuchi. Bhautika shabda, the words which describe the world of objects and relationships. Bhav is a vibration or an attitude or an intensity of reality. When you look at a circumstance, how real is that to you? You may look at this Swami up here and say, well, that's pretty phony. And you have the bhavana of the bhava, the feeling that this isn't very intensely real to you. Or it could go in one ear and come out the other ear. Or you have the intensity that says, hey, this is something I want to reflect in my own life. So, the bhava is the vibration, it's the attitude, it's the intensity of awareness in this attitude. Bhav samadhi, an intuition in which three exist. There's a subject, a meditator, there's an object, and a relationship between the two. Bhikshapatra, every sadhu will get to know that word very well. They're begging bowl. It's the patra in which all the bhiksha goes. Bhogi, one who enjoys. Bhua, the subtle world, that which is conceivable in the mind. Bhur, The gross world, that which is perceivable through the senses. Bhumi Shuddhi, the purification of land. Bindu, one point. Brahman, one who knows of divinity. Brahma eva brahma bhavanti, that is a Brahman who knows Brahma. Buddhi is the objective knowledge, the intellect, the intelligence, as contrasted with Mon, which is the opinions about things. So buddhi are all the nouns and verbs of experience. Bij is the seed or the natural name of any phenomena. So we have a seed of wisdom, which is aim. We have a seed of existence, which is reem. We have a seed of dissolution, of becoming something other than what it was, kleem. We have a seed of ma, which is shreem. We have so many seeds. Those are bijas. The chakra is a center of energy. Normally, a muladhar swadhisthana manipura anahat vishud and agnya chakra and sahasrar. These are the chakras. But wherever there is Shiva and Shakti in intimate relationship, you have a center of energy. That also forms a chakra. Whenever you have a satsang, that also forms a chakra. There's a center of energy. You are welcome into the chakra, which is the spandana, the vibration of or the circle of commitment. Chanda is a meter, a specified number of syllables. It's also a mathematical formula. Chandi is the name of the divine mother goddess, she who tears apart thoughts. Chedana means cutting asunder, tearing apart, cutting asunder. Chit is consciousness. Chit rupini, the capacity to evolve a form of consciousness, fully potential energy. It's not evolved, that would be chitta. Has come into manifested existence. Chit rupini means she can come into existence. She is potential. Chitta, the objects of awareness, or the totality of cognition. Anything you cognize or you recognize, or wherever there's an act of conscious knowingness, there is your chitta. Chitta are the totality of all things that are cognized. Darshan is the intuitive vision or the perception. Das is the servant of. So we all want to become Udas, the servant of Auma, Om, creation, circumstance, and transformation. So U is the circumstance of all existence, and Das is the servant of the circumstances of all existence. Devas are the forces of communion, the gods. Dharma is the ideal of perfection, the harmony of the universe, also known as religion. What do you rely upon? Of course you rely upon, I guess it says, in God we trust. So if you trust and you rely upon God, then that's your religion. Dharana is concentration, dhyana, meditation, drishti, perception, dukkha, pain. Daitya is duality or more multiplicity, as contrasted with adaitya, which was non-duality, oneness. Dvanda is a conflict or opposition. Gut is a container or a pot. Gut akash is contained space. Guru is an example, an inspiration, and a teacher. Ha is the purush, the divine consciousness. Hamsha, the Soham mantra, it also means a swan. The swan who flies to heaven is Soham, Hamsa. Havana is the fire ceremony. Hiti is a weapon. And Hitu is destruction, motivation. Hiranyagarbha is the golden womb, the first seed of existence. Hrim is Maya, the totality of existence, all that can be perceived through the senses, conceived in the mind and known through intuition and beyond. Ishwar is the principle of divine union, Shiva and Shakti, Sadashiva and Shakti Tattva become Ishwara. And that is Ardha Nari Ishwara is half male, half female, or Ardha Nari Ishwara is she's half female and half male. And the Supreme Lord. Jana is the logos or the embodiment of all knowledge. Janma, Parabdha Vashat Janma is birth. Janma Shreshtatvam, the ultimate of birth or the ultimate aim of living. Jayatvam is victory. Jap is the conscious repetition of a mantra as contrasted with Ajap, where the mantra is just playing in the background. Jaya is birth. And Jiva is the individual soul or life. A Gyani is someone who is wise. Gyanindriya is the five organs of knowledge, the eyes, ears, nose, tongue, and skin. Gyana is the wisdom. Gyanagyan is wisdom and ignorance. Gyanagyan, the two in comparison and contrast. Kama is an attribute. Kalyanam is welfare, karma, activities, karmindriyas, the five organs of actions, the upper appendages, lower appendages, tongue, reproductive organ, and anus. Kal is time. Kam is desire. Kamchukas are the limitations or the modes of perceptions. They are kal, niyati, raga, vidya, and kala. They are time, space, knowledge, action, activity, and attribute. Those are kanchukas. Kleem is a transformation towards perfection. Interesting, cause the cause. Law is manifested existence. E is the causal body. And anuswar is perfection. The cause of perfecting the union of the manifested existence, bringing it back into perfection in the causal body. Is clean. Kosh is a sheath, a covering, or a thickness. It's also an envelope, a container. Stick that ananda in the envelope. Lick it and put a stamp on it, and send it to all who you love. Krodh is anger. Kri do, kripa grace. What you do is what you get. Kri and pa. Kshara is that which is finite, which will not last, as compared or contrasted with Aksha. Kumbhak is the retention of air. Remember, Purak, Kumbhak, Rechak. Lingam is the symbol of divinity. It's also the subtle body, and it's also the male generative organ. Lobe is greed. Lok is the world or a paradigm of reality. We're not just sitting on the same plane as our deity, we're in the same space as our deity, we are actually in the same headspace as our deity, in the same paradigm of reality. Maha is the totality of all that can be possibly conceived, the body of nature. So you've got Bur, Bhuva, Shwa, and Maha. Maharlok is all that can possibly be conceived, all that has come into manifestation. Mahabhutas, the essential elements of existence, kidi, aptate, mortu, bom, earth, water, fire, air, and ether. Mahakash is unlimited space, is compared with Ghatakash, which is contained space. Mahamaya, the great measurement, the great limitation of consciousness. Mum, mine, as in possession. Mine, attachment. Mamta is my attachment. Mum is mine. Mon is mind. The subjective knowledge, all that I think about things, the adjectives and adverbs about my experiences. The Manamai Kosh is the world of concepts, ideas, and thoughts, of the consistency of thought, container of thought, manana, contemplation. Mangal means goodness and auspiciousness. Mantra, that which takes away your mind, the divine vibrations of sound. Matsa, jealousy. Ma, to measure
also means mother.
Mala is a guy or thing. Maya, the measurement or limitation of consciousness. Mud, attachment. Moh, ignorance. Mrityunjayatvam, victory over death. Mukti is liberation, otherwise known as self-realization. Nad is a subtle body of sound, or the sound we hear inside. Nam is name, nam and rup is form, so that every time you see a rup, you attach a name to it. That's a chandanam, that's a nadaityam, that's a gotam. So nam and rup, nididhyasana, it was deep meditation. Nididhyasana. Nir, without, nirgun, without qualities, nirhud, prohibited.
And also nir, water.
No, that's nir, that's a longi. Nirod, prohibition, cessation, or obstruction. Nirvikulp, without any kalpana, without any idea, and quite thoughtless. Nirvikulpana. Nirvikalpa samadhi, there's the existence of only one. We've gone so deep, so deep that there is no duality. We become adaitya. Nishkam, without desire. Nitya, eternal. Nitya karma, eternal activity. And so there are four kinds of karma. Remember, there was a sankshipt, which is past. It's over, done with, nothing you can do to change it. Vartman, it's right now, just happening, this instant. Bhavish is the future. It's the prarabdha karma. It's what was commenced in the past, the fruits of which are going to come to us in the future. And there is nitya karma, which is eternal. That's karma yoga. When we come into yoga because of our actions, that's nitya karma. Nivritti, involution. So you've got pravritti, nivritti. Pravritti is evolution, going out there, and nivritti is involution, coming back inside. Niyam is a discipline. It's also a budget. It's also niyam. Discipline is the best word. Nir, with a long E, is water. Nyati is space. Paramatma, the supreme soul, the Paramatma, the supreme soul. Panchkosh, the five sheaths or coverings. We have the Annamai, the Pranamai, the Manamai, the Vijnanamai, and the Anandamai, the five panchkosh. Pa means get. Pana, you get it. Kripa, you get. That's the grace. Pantam is to drink. Pibamyaham. I am drinking. While I am drinking, Garjagarjakshnamura. Madhu yabat pibamyaham. To drink and draw within and absorb. Pasha is a bondage or a bond. Phalitam, fruit. Prakash is illumination or intuitive awareness. Prakriti, the embodiment of nature. Pratyaksha, the union between the organs of knowledge and the objects of perception. Whenever my sight comes in contact with an object outside, there's pratyaksha. That moment of contact between the gyanindriya and the object of perception is pratyaksha. Pratyaya is the subtle body of thought. So now once I see a pratyaksha, I see, I identify a rup. There's a form. And immediately my mind conceives a relationship between that rup and the name of that form. I call that a chandana. I call that a Shree Maa. So that when there's a pratyaksha, there is a pratyaya. And if we can slow down this process, there will be a prakash. Pratyahara is drawing, withdrawing of the senses, or bringing all your senses inside. That means looking inside. pravritti, evolution, nivritti, involution. Prana is the breath or the life force or the inhalation. Prana, apana, atathabhyanam, udanam, chasamanika. Those are panchaprana, the five kinds of breath. Prana, inhalation, apana, exhalation, udana, bringing the breath up, dhyana, letting it go out, and samana, keeping it still. Inkumbha. Those are the kinds of breath. Pranamaya kosha is the world of breath, or the consistency of breath, or the paradigm of breath. Pranasiddhi, the attainment of perfection in the control of breath, or the control of your life force. Pranayam, the control of breath. Prarabdha karma, the actions begun in the past which will come to fruition in the future. Punya, merit. Purush, the individual soul or consciousness. Puja, worship, that which gives birth to merit. Ja means birth. Excuse me. Pu means punya. Now that's dhyana. Just to demonstrate. So puja is a worship, that which gives birth to merit. Purak is inhalation. Rakt is red, or blood, or passion, or desire. And rakta bij is the seed of desire. Rag is activity, becoming. Rajogun, the quality of passion. Rechak, exhalation. Purak, kumbak, rechak. The three phases of breath. Inhalation, retention, exhalation. Rishi is a seer. Ish means to see. Ra means again. Ish is sees, like Ishwara sees, and a rishi again sees, like Ishwara sees, and that is why she is rishi. Rohit, the radiance of the morning sun. Rup is form. Sa, with. That's different from swa. It's sa, rup, with form. Shada, eternal, always continuing and forever. Sada Shiva is the pure consciousness which is eternal, pure and ever continuing consciousness. Sadrishti, with perception. Samadhi, complete absorption in the perfection of union. Shaman is the equalizing breath or staying still in equilibrium. Shamashti is universal or cosmic, as contrasted with Vyashti or Vyakti, which is individual or particular. Samkshipta is the past. It also means abbreviated. Samshar is the world, the sea of all, the world of objects and relationships. Samskar is a certain tendency to manifest action in a specific way. That's also a proclivity and a natural necessity to perform behavior in a certain way, something that came with you. Sannyasi is established in truth. It literally was nyas, established within, sa, which is truth, is a traveler established truth within, or has established herself within truth. Shankalpa, a vow for spiritual growth, or the definition of a goal. Sarup, with form. Sarva Karana Karanam, the cause of all causes. Shatsang, the community of truth, a spiritual fellowship. Shangha is the community or the unity of our association with Sat, Satsang. Sattvagun, the quality of truth, purity. Satya, true existence. Satya Rupa, the form of true existence. Sobhagya, good fortune. Shabikalpa, with an idea. Salvikalpa Shamaditi, absorption in the union between I and thou. There's only the two of us. It's samadhi, absorption with an idea. There you are, and there's duality. Here I am. Savikalpa Sayuj is with union. Sadhana, spiritual discipline. Sadhana Shakti is the energy of spiritual discipline. Sadhika, the spiritual aspirant or the practitioner of discipline. Female is Shadu, a spiritual aspirant or practitioner of discipline. Male, Salokya, together in the same loka, in the same paradigm of reality, in the same location, and the same mindset. Samipya, performing the same activity. Seva, the privilege to demonstrate our love through effective action. Siddhatva Siddhi, the attainment of all attainments. Siddhi is attainment. Siddhapat, reciting a scripture from the beginning to the end. Stapan, the establishment. Shtul Sharir is the gross body. A stotram is a song in praise of God. Su means excellent. A sutra is a thread, an outline of major points. This is called the Kashyapa Sutra. Shwa means the causal world or that which is known through intuition. Swarupam, the intrinsic form, the intrinsic essence or nature. Swayambhuva, he who becomes of his own accord. Srishti, creation. Shabda, audible sound. Shabda Brahman, the sound of God, the infinite sound beyond conception. Shakti, pure energy. Shankhya philosophy, the philosophy of discrimination between the eternal and the temporal. So remember, Prakriti is always changing, so she is consistent in her change. Purush is always the same. And yoga is the attempt to unite the two. The eternal consciousness with the ever-changing nature. And that becomes yoga. Shanti, peace. Shiv, the consciousness of infinite goodness. Shlok is a Sanskrit verse. Shravan is hearing. Shrad is a memorial ceremony in honor of the departed. Shri, respect. And we call Shri, remember, Shah is Shanti. Ra is your mind. E is your heart. Shree is the perfection of peace in your mind and your heart. You want to be where you're at. You like it where you are. You're the person you like the most. Shree. Shree Vidya, the knowledge of the Divine Mother, the knowledge of the highest respect. Shuddha Vidya, pure knowledge. Tamogun, the quality of darkness. Tanmatras, the objects of perception, sight, sound, smell, taste, and feel. Rase rupe chigande cha sabde sparshach yogini. Tantra, the synthesis of the way to move from duality to unity. Every time we synthesize, every time we weave together all the various branches of our knowledge, we become tantrics. Tantra philosophy, the philosophy which synthesizes all knowledge into the path of unity. Tapa, the world of light and wisdom. Tapas, heat. Tapasya, any act of purification applying heat or spiritual discipline. Tarpana, offering to departed souls. Tattva, a principle. Tejas, illumination. Thra, that which takes away. Trishul, the trident, which stands for the unity of all the threes, all the trinities. Uma, Im Ring Klim, Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva, Srishti, Sthiti, Lai. All the threes come into Shiva's trishul, that's his weapon. The harmony of all the threes. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Twam, you. Ooh, circumstance. Ooh, das, the servant of circumstances. I accept everything that happens. And I try to use whatever influence I can to inspire something better, a better outcome. Udas, the servant of circumstances, the spirit of surrendering. Udana, bringing up the breath. Utapat, reading a scripture backwards. We start at the end and we work to the front. Vaikarik, An intuitional understanding or modified understanding, Vartaman, is a present karma, Vashat, bound or dependent upon, Prarabdha Vashat, Janma. Dependent upon your Prarabdha karma, you select the birth that you have selected. Vachak is an intellectual understanding of words, Vedanta philosophy, the philosophy of one reality. Vedic sabda, the words of wisdom, vidya, knowledge, vidya, avidya, knowledge and ignorance. Vikalp is an idea. Vimukti, he who resides in self-realization. Vyakti is individuality. Vyakti rup, the individual form. Jnana, any involuntary expulsion of air like gas belching or Swami sneezing. Vijnanamaya Kosha is the world of light, of the consistency, the substance of light and wisdom. Vritti are activities or modifications. Chitta vritti. Nirodh means the prohibition, the cessation, the complete stoppage of all changes or modifications in the objects of awareness. Iti yoga. Yam, to take control. Yatra is a pilgrimage. Yoga, the perfection of union. A yogi, one who has attained the perfection of union. Yuj is union. And so what we did here was every time anywhere in this text, we used a Sanskrit term. We took all of those terms from all the chapters and we made a glossary. And this is a wonderful place for you all to start your study of Sanskrit. These are all important words that you could use. As you chant all the scriptures that we have translated, you're going to come across these words again and again and again. And so this is a wonderful place for you to start just memorizing a vocabulary list. And that's why it was sufficiently important to put as a glossary at the end of this book. Om Sam Sarasvati Namaha. Namaste. And let's see if there are any questions.
We have a question from Sadhana Shakti.
Yes, please, Sadhana.
Can you please talk about the natural instinct to protect ourselves? And is that different from being selfish?
Yes, that is different from being selfish. Because you need to protect yourself in order to realize God. But being selfish means to be attached to worldly things and relationships and outcomes of your actions so that you will get the major portion of the fruits of those actions and with sharing a lesser portion with other people. So it is not wrong to preserve yourself in order for you to progress in spirituality. But it is wrong to be selfish and say, we did this work together, but I get the majority of the profit and you can have a little token of my appreciation. Why don't we share according to our contributions? If you're trying to get an undue advantage, that is selfish. But if you're trying to preserve yourself, you're working for the big self, the self with a capital S. Yes, please.
Bhashat, is that different from the nyasas that we're doing?
Yes.
What is the difference?
Bhashat.
Oh.
Next.
We have a question from Koshiki.
Yes, please, Koshiki. Namaste.
Could you please speak about the seven levels of existence or consciousness? I don't understand beyond Bhu, Bhuva, and Swa.
Bhur is the world of the gross body, what I can see, empirically verify through my senses. Bhuva is the world of the subtle body, what I can think about. Swa is the causal body, which I know through meditation, intuition, and beyond. And Maha is all those things that I could possibly conceive, but I can't see that far. But I know that they're not devoid of existence just because I can't see that far. I can dream that far. I can expand my dream to think that I can imagine that they're there. Everything that is imaginable in existence, whether it be in the Milky Way or on Saturn or on Pluto or in the next galaxy, it doesn't matter. It's all part of the Maharlok. It's potentially conceivable. Now, jhana is all those forms that are potentially conceivable. They all have a name and they all have a form. Every rupa has a naam. So the correspondence between all the rupas, or that you can potentially conceive, and all the naams, or that you can potentially name to all those forms, that is the world of knowledge. All knowledge. I mean, not just the knowledge of everything I've learned, the dictionary, but the knowledge of all the things I haven't learned. What is it called in another name, in another planet, in another galaxy? I don't know, but it's potentially, I can learn. All that knowledge is like the logos. It's the body, the embodiment of all knowledge. And tama is all that knowledge emanates from light. So the light, the purity, the clarity, all the wisdom, the light of wisdom, which encompasses all the names and all the knowledge and all the forms that could be potentially conceived, is tapalok. And satyam is the loka, the of satchit anam, the true existence and infinite consciousness is pure bliss. And all I can perceive is the bliss of infinite consciousness. That is the true existence, which is the substratum of all the light and all the wisdom, which is the foundation of all the knowledge which can possibly be conceived, which is upon which all the manifestations have come into manifestation, which could be possibly manifested, and after which I can know them through meditation or conceive them in my mind or actually open my eyes and perceive them. And those are the seven lokas: bhur, vua, swa, maha, janaha, tapaha, satyam. Yes, please.
We have a question from Ramya.
Namaste, Rami Mami.
The attitude of wisdom in all ideals is one. What is the attitude of wisdom?
Oh, Rami. Sat, chit, ekam, brahma. What is the attitude of wisdom? I see in every perception, in every relationship, in every bhavana, this intensity of reality that sat, true existence, chit, infinite consciousness, ekam, one brahma, supreme divinity. What is the attitude of wisdom? Rami, actually, it's a realization. It's the bliss of being submerged in that attitude, in that bhavana, in that feeling of knowingness and knowing the unity in within the diversity. Every time we look at the multiplicity of objects and attitudes and relationships that are manifest, we see within them the unity and the love and the joy and the privilege. Sat, chit, ekam, brahma. How can one, I'm sorry, you're going to have to ask Nanda about that. The answer is neti, neti. Now, what does that mean? Sat, chit, anam. The attitude of wisdom.
We have a question from Joshua.
Namaste, Joshua.
Namaste. The mind and ego are tricky and sometimes like to project themselves as my guru speaking. How do we know when you are speaking to us and when it's our own mind playing tricks on us?
Joshua, if the words that you hear inside are counseling you to do the right thing, to take pains to do it perfectly as best as you can possibly make it manifest. Or if they are counseling you to surrender your selfishness and give up your egotistical attachments and share more and give more and do the very, very best that you possibly can, reach for the highest, you know it comes from Ma and me. And if the words that you're hearing inside are saying, you can cut the corners here, and you can sweep the dust under the rug, and you don't have to do it fully and completely and perfectly, and do it quickly and get it over with, and know that to be born of your ego. And let that be the criteria. If the counsel that you hear is abjuring you to do the very, very best and the most divine and share with the greatest number of people the very best thing that you could possibly share, that came directly from Shree Maa. And anything else came from me.
We have a question from Shivani.
Namaste, Shivani.
What is unique about a bija syllable as opposed to other Sanskrit syllables?
Do you know, every object and every relationship in existence has two names. There is a name that we agreed to call it. This is a Swamiji. This is a book. Used to be. Now it's an iPad holding a book. But everything, those are all agreed upon names in the language that we're speaking. In another language, it's Boyachi. And we agreed to call it that in another language. But in this language, we're speaking in English, we are saying that this is a Swamiji and that's a book. Now, those are agreed upon names, but there's more to that object. There's another name. What inside that object, inside every object, there is this movement going on. And there's this rotation of atoms and molecules and the circulatory system, and all the juices are flowing throughout this body, and they are circulating through the nadis and through the veins and through the all throughout the body. There's this movement going on. Throughout every body, there's protons, neutrons, electrons, quarks. The nucleus is revolving around the atom. There's a Higgs boson. There's all of this movement going on, and every movement creates a vibration, and every vibration creates a sound, and every sound is expressible by a letter, which is the Bij mantra, the seed mantra, the Bija. What is the vibration calling of that object? What is he calling himself? You called it a Swami. Somebody even said Swami Ji. But what is this object calling itself? Within this object are all these vibrations. What are these vibrations saying? The Rishi said, Aim is saying wisdom, and Reem is saying all of Maya, and Kleem is saying continuous transformation. And they came up with so many expressions. The closest approximation to the sound that this object is making itself. What is this vibration calling itself? Is it Bij mantra? That's what, how a Bij mantra is different from a regular word or shabda. The shabda is a dictionary meaning, a vachart. We agreed upon, we're going to agree to call this guy a human being. Some of you may doubt and some of you may refute, but for purposes of this discussion, we'll call this object human being. Now, inside this human being, there's all this vibration going on, and all that vibration is making a sound, and that sound is expressible by a Bij mantra. What is your Bij mantra? Look inside yourselves and discover your own Bij. You will find out who you really are. Swarupa Nanda, Adhaitya Nanda, Ekatma Nanda, Parvati Chandana, who exudes the sweetness and the fragrance of most highly desired. Through her every action, through her every word, she just exudes sweet fragrance which captivates all. Shree Maa, the mother of respect. Every one of you look with inside yourselves, you will find your Bij mantra. What is your vibration saying to the world?
We have a question from Vivekananda.
Namaste, Vivek.
In relation to the glossary, Prana Siddhi, is Asana Siddhi a prerequisite for Prana Siddhi? What are the attributes and attainments of Prana Siddhi?
Asana Siddhi will be a prerequisite to achieving Prana Siddhi. And Asana Siddhi means you learned how to sit still. And generally, to do that, we sit in an asana. And there are various degrees and gradations of asana siddhi. So a guy who sits for 1 hour has got asana siddhi. And a guy who sits for 3 hours has a different attainment of asana siddhi. And the lady who sits for 7 hours has a different understanding of asana siddhi. And the person who sits for 10 hours in one posture without moving, without drinking water, without going to the bathroom, without making a mess wherever they sit, they have achieved another degree, another intensity of asana siddhi, just as we spoke about dharma being the path and the destination, and tapasya and sadhana being the path and the destination. There is no end to anantha. Hori ananta, hari kotha ananta. So there is no end. So asana siddhi has no end if you sit for 24 hours a day for many, many days. That will be another level of asana siddhi, another level of intensity. So generally speaking, you want to sit as long as you can, and we're using the texts of Sanskrit as the stories which regulate our breath. They regulate the length of our asana. They regulate they confine our thoughts. We are reading the history of how did I achieve asana siddhi, and how did that asana siddhi give me prana siddhi, and how did that prana siddhi bring me from the anamaya kosha to the pranamaya kosha, and how did the pranamaya kosha brought me to the manamaya kosha. And now I'm thinking and I'm watching the history of me. I'm the businessman who gave up my business to sit in a temple on the bank of the river and chant the chandi every day. One day, we wake up and say, oh, there's a remarkable resemblance to my story. In fact, that chandi pot is the history of me. Om Sam Sarasvati Namaha. Namaste.